The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text number 8, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on March 28, 1974, in Bombay, India.
Paritrana sadhuna vinasa chaduskita dharma samasthapana thaya sambhamani divi. So, the routine work of Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, how and when He appears. Because Krishna is the proprietor of all planets. Bhoktam yagyatapasam sarvaloka maheswaram. Sarvaloka, loka means planets, all universes. There are innumerable universes, unlimited number. And those universes are coming out within the breathing period of Mahavishnu. Jasyaika nishasita kala mathavalambya jivanti loma vilaja jagadanna natha. Jagadanna means universe. Jagadanna natha, plural number. There are innumerable universes. And on each universe, there is a predominating deity who is called Lord Brahma. Similarly, in each and every universe, there are innumerable planets. Jasya prabha prabhavato jagadanna koti kotisu asesa vasudhadi vibhuti vinnam. In each universe, there are innumerable planets, and each planet is of different atmosphere. The atmosphere of one planet is not equal to the other. This is God's creation. He can't see no situ jagat. All these innumerable universes, they are sustained by one plenary portion of Krishna. Krishna, in his Vibhuti Yoga, he has explained to Arjuna, Atma bahunayatena kinyatena tavajna vishtrabhya aham idam krishnam ekanshina sthitu yoga. So Krishna is staying within this universe. Annantarastham paramanachayantarastham. Not only within the universes, but within the atoms. Paramanu chayantas. In this way, Krishna is ruling over the material creation. Ekappasau rachayatam jagadanna koti. There are many places in Vedic literature wherein we understand there are innumerable universes. We cannot take account of one universe. And Krishna has to take account of all these universes, how things are going on. This material world is ekamsa. Out of Krishna's whole creation, this is one-fourth manifestation of His creative energy. Ekamsa. The three-fourth of the creative energy is in the spiritual world. So, this material world means the living entities are given chance. They have come here to enjoy. Krishna bhuliya jeevi bhogavancha kare pasate maya tare japotiya dhare. When living entity is eternal servant of Krishna, when he, instead of becoming servant of Krishna, wants to imitate Krishna to enjoy, because the enjoyer is Krishna, bhokta. Bhoktaram jagratapasam, sarvalokamayasam. But when we try to imitate Krishna, just like here also we can see practically, everyone is trying to become as big or small Ishvara, Krishna. Ishvara is Krishna, Ishvara Parama Krishna. But here the struggle is that everyone is trying to become Ishvara. Nobody wants to become servant. Although he is servant of Maya, he cannot be Ishvara constitutionally, any one of us. This is called illusion. Actually we are servant, but we are trying to become Ishvara. This is called Maya. So, this position of the living entity is called dharmasya glani. Discrepancy of the constitutional position. Actually, I am servant, but I am trying to become master. This is called dharmasya glani. So, when the world is full, of course there are devotees who are trying to become servant. They are trying. The devotional service means, Krishna consciousness means to train people how to become servant of God. That is all. Because everyone is under the impression that I am God, I am master, I am proprietor. This illusion. To dissipate this illusion and to put him into the right position, that you are not master, you are not enjoyer, you are simply eternal servant of Krishna. If you remain in that position, then you are happy. If you artificially try to become Krishna, that is your anandi. Artificial thing will never give us any pleasure. Prakriti and Purush. Krishna is the Purusha. Purusha. Parabrahma paramdhama pavitram parabrahma. Purusham adyam shasatam. He is Purusha. We are Prakriti. Aparaprakriti. Paraprakriti. This matter, bhumi rapanala vayu. Earth, water, fire, air, sky, mind, intelligence and false ego, they are all material. That is the sky. And aparayam, these are inferior material nature. And there is another superior nature, that is also the sky. Or energy. Aparayam itastu vidhi me prakritim para jiva bhuta mahava. We living entities, we are Prakriti. We are not Purusha. But we are trying to become Purusha. Suppose a woman artificially wants to become man, that is very troublesome. Similarly, actually our position is Prakriti. Prakriti means enjoyed, one who is enjoyed. And Purusha means one who is enjoyer. So, our position is to be enjoyed, but we are trying to become enjoyer. Our position is to be predominated, but we are trying to become predominator. That is called dharmasya glani, bhavati bharat. But there are certain persons who are above this mistake, illusory energy. Who are those? The devotees. The devotees who are called sadhu. Sadhu, there is a word, sadhu. Sadhu means honest, good behavior. They are called sadhu. There is description of sadhu, sadhava, sadhu bhushana. what are they? Sadhu. Titiksava karunika surida sarvabhutana ajata satrava shantas sadhava sadhu bhutana. This is the description of sadhu. Sadhu does not mean for livelihood, change the collar of the garment or having big beard and become sadhu. No. Sadhu means devotee. Sadhu means first class devotee. That is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Sadhu reva samantabha. Sammag bhavasita hisa. Who is that man? Apite sudurachara bhajate mamananava. Sadhu reva samantabha. One who is fully engaged, bhajate mamananava, he has no other engagement. Not partial. Some percentage for this purpose, some percentage for that purpose. No. Samma, wholeheartedly, 24 hours, engaged in the service of the Lord, he is sadhu. He is sadhu. Apidesu durachara. Even if you find some fault in him, because sadhu is sadhu bhusana, you cannot find fault in him. Cannot find fault. But even though if you find some fault, but if you find that he is strictly engaged in the service of the Lord, Krishna said, he is sadhu. Here it is said, paritranaya sadhuna. What is the verse number? Yes. Verse number. Paritranaya sadhuna. As sadhu is always engaged, dedicated to the service of the Lord. He has no other business. That is sadhu. So, Krishna also is always anxious to give them protection. It's like a child is adherent to the parents. He does not know anything else except his father and mother. Similarly, the parents are also very much anxious to give protection to the child. This is reciprocal. If you depend on Krishna fully and simply engage yourself in his service, then you are sadhu. And Krishna is always very much anxious to give you protection. Konteya pratijanihi name bhakta pranasati. This is natural. You can say, why Krishna is so partial to the sadhus? No. He gives protection to everyone. Without his protection, nobody can live. That's a fact. But he gives special protection to the sadhu, to the devotee. That is natural. Samohang sarva-bhuteshu name desasti na priya. Krishna says, I am equal to everyone. Unless he is equal to everyone, how he can be the Supreme Lord? He is equal. Jetu bhajanti maam pritya teshu te mai. But one who is engaged in love and affection in my service, I am especially attentive to him. That is not partiality. That is his special prerogative. The example is that the sun is equally distributing sunshine. Anyone can take advantage of it. But if somebody does not take advantage of it, if he closes his door and windows, if he wants to remain in darkness, so what sun can do? Similarly, Krishna appears for everyone. Krishna says, sarva-dhanmān paritajya-māmekaṁ saranaṁ vaja. You take shelter unto me. But we shall not do that. Instead of Krishna, we shall find out so many imitation Krishna and take shelter of them. This is our fault. This is not Krishna's partiality. Krishna is open to everyone. But we shall go to some rascal who falsely declares himself, I am incarnation of God, incarnation of Krishna, and I will go there. Then show some magic. He does not want to see the magic of Krishna. He wants to see some false magic of an imitation Krishna. That is the fault. Why should we go to anyone else when Krishna is there? When Krishna's instruction is there in the shape of Bhagavad Gita, why shall I read any nonsense book? That is my fault. Can anyone give better instruction than Krishna for solving all the problems of the world? No, that is not possible. But still, we shall find out some imitation Krishna. This is our ill-luck, misfortune. Therefore, they are called duskritino. The word is used here. Paritrana sadhunam vinasayacha duskita. Duskita means miscreants. Kriti means, this is explained in the 7th chapter more elaborately. Namada prabhadate duskitina naradhama. Naman pravadante mūḍhā duṣkṛtina naradhama. Another place, this the word duṣkṛti is used. Duṣkṛti means, kṛti means meritorious. One who has got merit, nice merit. But it is employed for sinful activities. They are called duṣkṛti. And one who uses his merit for pious activities, he is called Sukriti. Chaturvidha bhajante mam Sukriti na Arjuna. Those are Sukriti na, pious. They can be engaged in devotional service. Chaturvidha bhajante, this word bhajan is used. Bhajan is meant for the Sukriti na, those who are pious, not the impious. Bhajan is not possible for the impious, because Krishna says, Namana duskitina mūḍhā pravadante narādhama. They cannot take to bhajan. Māyā aparita jñāna. They pose themselves as very much advanced, but actually māyā has taken away their knowledge. They cannot understand Krishna. They will accept something imitation. So, Krishna's purpose of appearing is mentioned here. Paritrana sadhunam vinasayacha duskita. Vinasaya means for annihilating, for killing. So Krishna's killing is also good for the person who is killed by Krishna. And another killing is to dissipate his ignorance. This is us. One is in ignorance. He does not know what is the value of life. Therefore, Krishna wants to kill his ignorance and give him real knowledge. That is also vinasaya. Vinasa, killing his ignorance. So the Bhagavad Gita is going on for two varieties of business. One business is to give relief to the sadhu, to the devotee. And another business is to kill ignorance or kill personally the duskritino. Those are non-devotees. For them, killing business. But the killing is also good for them. Because Krishna is absolute. Either Krishna love somebody or kill somebody, the result is the same. That is called absolute. Just like father or mother loves some child and chastises the other, the result is the same. Affection. There is no jealousy. Suppose one child is diseased another child is healthy. The healthy child is lean, supplied with nice foodstuff. And the diseased child, mother says, oh no, you cannot eat. You go out, eat it out from here. That is not that mother is unkind to the child. She is all kind. So Krishna's killing and Krishna's supporting is the same. There is affection. He therefore comes here. Yada yada hi dharmasya glani bhavati bharat. Here we have come falsely to become enjoyer. Falsely. Suppose I am American or Indian. I am enjoying my life very nicely. I have got everything complete. But it is no guarantee that next life you shall become American and you will be situated in the same position. Therefore my enjoyment, so-called enjoyment, is false enjoyment, temporary. It will not stay because I will have to change body. I will have to change body. There is no guarantee. This is the law of nature. Dukkhalam asashvatam. It is the place for miseries, and that is also temporary. If you want to make some compromise, never mind. It is a place of miseries. I will stay here comfortably as much as possible. But Krishna says, asashvatam. Even if you make some compromise arrangement, you cannot stay here. You will be kicked out. As soon as you think, now I have a very nice building, very nice wife and children, everything is properly settled. Now I am happy. Next day, get out. Finish. This is the law. Daivijishagunami mumumaya durutvaya. So foolish people, they think that now I am settled. What is your settlement? First of all, make it a settlement that you shall be allowed to stay here. If there is no such guarantee, then what is the settlement? Next life you may become a cat, a dog, according to your mentality. But these foolish people, they do not know it. They think that this is all right. This is not all right. The sadhu, they can understand that this life is preparation for next life. So that is also described in the Bhagavad Gita. Janti deva mrita devan, pitani jnanti pitani mrita bhutani janti bhutejya, madhyajino bhi janti ma. If you prepare yourself as the karmis do, to be elevated to the higher planetary system, sarva-loka, jana-loka, maha-loka, tapo-loka, brahma-loka, that is very good. But Krishna says, abrahma-bhuvana-lokana punarabhattina-arjuna. Even if you go to the brahma-loka, there is no guarantee you have to come back here again. Kine-punne-puno-matta-lokam-visanti. These are the statements of Bhagavad Gita. We should study Bhagavad Gita very nicely. You can understand. But madhyadino pijanti ma. If you prepare your life to become a perfect, pure devotee of Krishna, then you go to Krishna. What is the difference between going to the Brahma Loka and Krishna Loka? If you go to Krishna Loka, jadgatyana nivartante tadhama paramamama, then you will have got to return again to accept another material body. You go to Krishna means you go with your spiritual body, non-material body. Takta dehang punarjanma naiti mameti kaunteya. So we should cultivate knowledge in that way, that I am prepared for the next life. So somebody is preparing for the next life to go to the heavenly planet, and somebody is going to the Pithri Loka. Somebody wants to remain within this world as human being or even the animals. Because if we contact with the modes of ignorance, then adhogacchanti tamasa. These are the rules of prakriti. Prakriti kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasa. Gunai karmani. As you are associating with the particular type of the modes of material nature, you are preparing your next life. But these foolish persons, they do not know what is next life, whether there is birth, ignorance, mulha. They have been described as mulha. They do not know their duties. They are thinking that this life is all in all and there is no next life because they cannot think of duskritina. If for them there is next life, then they have to stop their nefarious activities. But they do not like. They think, no, there is no next life. Let us do whatever you like. Enjoy. But nature will not give you. Just like if you think that I'm associating with some infectious disease, it will not affect me. No, you may think so, but it will affect you. That's a fact. Similarly, we may foolishly think that we are doing all nonsense things. Jagannagnavittista adhogacchanti tamasa. In tamasic gun, in ignorance, we are doing so many nasty things. We may think that this will not affect. But no, it will affect. The same example. If you infect some disease, you will have to suffer. It is nature's law. You cannot avoid it. Similarly, urdham gacchanti sattastva madhye tisthanti rajasa jaghanna gunavittista adhogacchanti tamasa. Adhogacchanti tamasa. And otherwise, how you can explain so many abominable forms of life? Even up to the worm in the stool. This is also life. And Brahma is also life. Why the differences? According to karma. Karmanadeva, infection. As you infect, as you associate. Karanam gunasangasra. These are all explained. Why one is this stool worm and why one is not Brahma? The karanam gunasangas, as we are associating with the laws of material nature, we are infecting and we are getting the next body. So this is our position. We are spirit soul, pure, as Krishna is pure. We are part and parcel of Krishna. We are also pure. That is qualitative equality, not quantitative. Krishna is the great, we are the small. Anoraniyana mahatomahiyana. He is mahatomaniyana, we are anoraniyana. We are ano, atomic. Atomic sparks of Krishna. So actually we are pure. But as we associate with the qualities of material nature, we become impure. Therefore, this Krishna consciousness movement is to purify the impure living entities. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's movement. Cheta dharpana marjanam bhava mahadavagni nibbhava. If you become purified, cheta dharpana, where the purificatory process begins, from the heart, cheta dharpana, chitta, desires. We have got so many desires, and Krishna is so kind. He fulfills your desire, my desire. Whatever you like, you can do. But you'll never be happy in that way. Therefore Krishna says, give up all this nonsense desire. Simply surrender unto me. That is your only business. So, that is, as we have discussed in the last verse, for it, jadadadahi dharma sagrani bhavati, tatatmanam sijamaham, grani bhavati bhavati. Grani. We should not desire anything except serving Krishna. That is our fulfillment of life. Sarvapadhi vinirmuktam. Or, annavilasita sunnam. We should not desire anything, except we simply desire how to serve Krishna, how to remain a pure devotee of Krishna. Then our life is successful. Annavilasita sunnam jnana karma vanabhritam. Even we should not speculate so-called knowledge. Now what kind of knowledge we can get? We are deficient, imperfect in so many ways. So what is the use of speculating our knowledge? Therefore jnana and karma, fruitive activities. Let me work hard and get the result and enjoy. This is called karma. And jnana means speculative knowledge. So, Rupa Goswami says, annavilasita sunnam jnana karma anabritam. Anupullena krishnanu silanam. Simply cultivating Krishna consciousness favorably, not unfavorably. Krishna consciousness, just like demons, like conscious. He was also Krishna conscious. So what was his purpose? He was conscious. He was making plan how to kill Krishna. That's all. That is not anukul. Anukulena. We should be Krishna conscious favorably. What Krishna wants and how can I serve him? And that is anukul. Thank you very much.